Hello everybody. In this video, I'm super excited to provide to you some information directly from the NVC. This is based on minutes of a meeting that took place between the American Immigration Lawyers Association and the National Visa Center. In that meeting, they answered a lot of questions that all of us want to know. For example, what happens with cases that are currently documentarily qualified and are currently stuck and sitting at NVC? When are they going to be sent to the U.S. embassies? How many cases are currently pending at the NVC? Whether they're immigrant visas, whether they're K-1 visas, and what's going to happen with those cases in the next few months? Will NVC require the applicants to update their information again, including paying for new fees for affidavit of support and the DS forms? We'll answer those questions as well. Should applicants continue to submit DS-260 forms even though they know that the U.S. embassies and consulates that they are specifically designated for are closed? Should they continue to do so? We'll answer those questions as well. What's the status of NVC expedited cases? I've been talking about it a lot. Will NVC continue to entertain those expedited requests? And what's the best way to do so? We'll answer those questions as well. So make sure you stick to the end of this video. I'm going to go over all these questions because they all were presented at those minutes. And I want to make sure you're going to get this information, because I know a lot of you guys are anxious, a lot of you guys are waiting, and that's what I'm here for, providing this information back to you. So let's dive right in. Hello everybody, and welcome back to our immigration channel. This is a place where we get the most up-to-date immigration news, immigration updates, and everything else that you need to make your immigration journey less stressful. My name is Jacob Sapochnick, and I'm an immigration attorney located in San Diego, California, and I help clients in all 50 states. Once again, if you're here for the first time, make sure to subscribe to our channel so you don't miss any of our videos. Click the notification bell and also give us a big like so YouTube is going to be able to show this video to more people just like you. In this video, I'm going to give you the most up-to-date information coming straight from the NVC with questions that you have probably, and I want to be able to give that information back to you right now. So let's jump right in. What is the volume of immigrant visa cases that are currently being processed at NVC at the moment? During fiscal year 2020, NVC reviewed and processed 77,000 cases per month. This is absolutely crazy. Next question. What is the number of K-1 visas, non-immigrant K-1 visas, that NVC processed every single month? They responded that every single month they process 2,500 K-1 visas, 2,500 K-1 visas per month during fiscal year 2020. And just so you know, out of all the cases that are being processed at NVC, 25% of those cases are being represented by attorneys. So remember, they've got thousands of cases, and based on their survey, 25% of all NVC cases are being represented by attorneys, which is great, because that means that those cases, at least hopefully, are done correctly and will allow NVC to push them through the pile faster, hopefully avoiding further delays. The next topic to discuss is, how is NVC handling cases that are documentarily qualified for posts, embassies and consulates that have not yet resumed normal processing, and some of them are closed and some of them are only taking emergency appointments? How are these documentarily qualified cases being handled? Are they in some sort of a queue prioritized by date of qualification? Is there a specific standard that NVC is taking to prioritize those cases that are, like I said, that are documentarily qualified and they're just sitting there at NVC? And here's the response of NVC. NVC continues to schedule cases only for posts able to conduct interviews. Due to the COVID-19 pandemic, NVC is warehousing cases for consular sections that have not been able to resume routine immigrant visa processing, and cases with visa categories subject to the various presidential proclamations. Other than age-out cases, inter-country adoption and expedites, per 9 FAM 504.46, upon visa availability, NVC schedules immigrant visa appointments for visa categories that are able to proceed in the chronological order of documentary complete applicants within each visa class, based on post capacity, host country, and Department of State guidance on operating safely during the pandemic also weigh on this approach. NVC will maintain this approach as post-resume routine visa services. So as you can see, directly from NVC, they'll be using a chronological order based on the date the cases were documentary qualified, and also it will depend on the specific post. So if the posts are able to start receiving those cases, then NVC will start sending them in the order that they were documentary qualified in the first place. The only exceptions are expedited cases, intercountry adoptions, and age-out cases. That's why, as I mentioned before, continuing to expedite if you can is crucial right now, because that's the only way you can get cases out of the chronological queue and get them to be shipped to the US embassies. The next topic is, how many cases are actually documentary qualified sitting at NVC under the different categories, employment, family, EB-5? Let's see what NVC has to say about that. As of January 25th, 2021, NVC's queue of documentary complete employment-based or family-sponsored cases, including family preference and immediate relative cases, with the visa number available waiting for an immigrant visa interview is family-sponsored 312,782 cases, employment 11,504 cases pending, EB-5 3,930 cases. That's really good information, so we can see that majority of cases that are being warehoused, they specifically said warehouse because embassies are not able to receive them, are family petitions that are stuck at NVC. We have definitely less employment-based cases, and of course, the least EB-5 cases for now. The biggest crisis right now is with immigrant visa cases, as you can see, over 300,000 cases sitting warehoused at the NVC. Next topic is, once embassies and consulates reopen fully, will NVC be sending the cases that are documentary qualified directly to the post based on the request from the post first? So the post will contact the NVC and will state, we are ready to receive the cases, can you send them to us? Is this the right procedure? And if so, should applicants be contacting the NVC once their embassies or consulates are reopened and request the NVC to be sending the files to their respective posts? Here's what NVC has to say. As post-specific conditions permit, NVC will schedule immigrant visa interviews based on post capacity. Posts generally don't request specific files. Instead, they provide interview capacity by visa category. Posts will determine the volume of visa services that they can provide while prioritizing the health and safety of consular staff and applicants. Upon visa availability, NVC fills their available appointment capacity in the first-in, first-out manner based on the date the case was deemed documentary complete. As you can see, the common presumption that attorneys or applicants should be contacting NVC to let them know that the posts are open and requesting them to send cases to the posts is not correct. What NVC is actually doing, they're receiving data from the specific embassies and consulates as to their visa capacity and availability, and then they schedule those cases based on the priority of them being documentary qualified, as I mentioned before. NVC also confirmed that embassies and consulates do not contact NVC requesting specific files. It's based on visa availability and their capacity to conduct interviews. Again, we still believe that doing a follow-up with NVC is prudent to make sure that your case is being worked on, or at least your case is being considered to be sent to the embassy once those embassies are fully open and ready to schedule cases. Another question we want to bring up is, what happens if affidavit of support, supporting documents, and other documents submitted to the NVC is now more than 6 months old? Will applicants be required to submit new documents and update that information? NVC clearly confirmed that you don't need to provide any new documents, any new affidavit of support, and supporting documents, even if your documents are more than 6 months old. That has been confirmed. Another question we want to address is, should applicants continue to submit their DS-260 forms online even if they know that their respective consulates or embassies are currently closed? Here's what NVC had to say about that. Since NVC has not stopped processing cases, applicants should continue to send their fees, forms, and documents to NVC even if their assigned embassy continues to be restricted in their ability to provide visa services due to local COVID-19 health restrictions and resource limitations. Completing the DS-260 form is a necessary step towards completing NVC pre-processing and scheduling of an immigrant visa interview. Submitting the DS-260 form will enable NVC to commence the review process, perform the known adjudicatory functions, and be ready for when post-resume all routine visa operations. So as you can see, and that's a question I've been getting a lot, you should not stop filing the DS-260 forms online. Continue the process as you get the email from NVC. All that will continue to be processed. All that should be continued because, as the NVC indicated, it will stop the application process if you fail to submit the DS-260 form or fail to follow the procedure as indicated in their instructions. Another question that was addressed is, what happens when cases actually sent to the US Embassy are sitting in the embassy, but then the embassy realizes that they are out of capacity, they don't have enough officers, they don't have enough space to interview? Will those files be returned to NVC to continue stay there and wait for the consulate to resume routine visa processing? And the answer of the NVC was no. All cases that are sent to the embassy and are about to be scheduled for interview remain at the embassy. Nothing is being shipped back to NVC. And the reason is because embassy conditions change on a daily basis. So if 1 week or 2 weeks, they're overbooked, they're busy, cases will just remain in the embassy, and as soon as they're ready to continue processing, they'll reschedule those cases for an interview. Let's talk about emergency expedited cases. The question was for NVC, should people continue to do expedited cases if they feel that they need an emergency appointment or faster processing because they fall under the requirements of expedited? The answer was yes. Continue to do so, whether you do it with an attorney or by yourself, by using the NVC expedited email and not the online inquiry form. If you use the online inquiry form, your expedited request will be delayed. But they specifically emphasize they still continue to entertain expedited cases, whether it's for K-1, CR-1 cases, and all other family petitions that meet the requirements of the NIE exceptions. Those are still the most effective ways to get yourself a faster interview if you qualify, instead of just sitting and waiting. Another question that was brought to the NVC is, how did the COVID-19 pandemic impact their staffing capabilities and also their processing power with cases? So NVC responded that they abide by the rules, obviously, and they have all the precautions in place, and quite a few of their staff is working remotely, continuing to process cases. So NVC never stopped working. They continue to working. It's a little bit slower, obviously, because of the huge volume and the fact that they have become almost like a warehousing facility for a lot of these cases, but they continue to work, and a lot of their staff is working remotely. So don't worry, your cases is still being worked on. Another important question that was brought to the NVC was, how long does it take for a case to get from USCIS once your petition is approved, like an I-130 or I-129F, how long does it take from the moment it was approved by USCIS to reach NVC for further processing? And here's what they had to say. Once USCIS approves a petition for paper-based cases, it typically takes 4 to 6 weeks for the physical petition to reach NVC. After receiving an I-797 approval notice from USCIS, please allow the allotted time before contacting NVC about a case. This helps ensure USCIS has sufficient time to mail the case and for NVC to enter it into our database. So there you have it, 4 to 6 weeks from USCIS approval until the file actually gets to NVC and they start working on the case. Finally, if your case was terminated because of 1 year of no activity, the best way to reopen it is contact NVC through the public inquiry form, the online form, and submit documents to prove that you tried, that you maintained contact, and your case was terminated in error. It happens right now, and they'll be able to reopen your case. And I think that's pretty useful information to know. So we gave you a lot of information here. Hopefully that was helpful for a lot of you. I know that some of these topics we covered in this video, I've been getting a lot of questions in the comments and direct messages. And hopefully the most up-to-date information provided in this video will help you navigate the visa process. I know many of you are anxious. You're wondering when embassies are going to reopen. They are reopening step by step. Every country has their own procedures. But this information is important for you to understand how to behave with NVC while your cases are sitting there, documentary qualified, waiting for the appointment at the US Embassy. So once again, if you have questions, put them in the comments below. I'm curious to know what other videos I can make on related topics. If you need my help, set up a consultation, make sure you text the number here, 619-483-4549, and set up an individual consultation so we can talk about your case in specific. So we can talk about your case specifically. Once again, thanks for watching, and I'll see you in our next video.